What's up, Mr. here. Welcome back to my channel. So I wanted to talk about Inkdrop version 5.8.0, which I've been working on the last 2 months. And yeah, it's finally, I think it's stable enough to release. And so I'd like to talk about what's new in version 5.8. And yeah, it comes with a bunch of improvements, like this one is about internet workflow improvements. So Inkdrop can help you connect your nodes, multiple nodes across multiple nodes. So you've got backlink support. So for example, this node is a script of the video, one of the video tutorials, which is about issue-driven text noting workflow, and it'll be out soon. And this node has a backlinks, two backlinks, and they are displayed here. And this one is about my daily journal, and this one is the part four. And I have a link to the part three note item here, so you can go back quickly. So it just helps you work on taking notes across multiple nodes, which is useful. So this is automatically displayed on top of the preview pane. And so this is a side-by-side view, and the editor itself doesn't have a backlink view on top of the editor. But if you are viewing notes, it automatically displays the note metadata instead of editor drawer. So that the information pane has been moved from the editor drawer to here, so that you can quickly check out note information and backlinks. I think it's more useful because I really checked the editor drawer, because it's annoying to toggle the editor drawer. So I think it's useful. And also you can change the created date and updated date like so. So if you wanna change the update date manually, you can edit like this. Yeah. So this is a script for making a video tutorial. So in sense is like I learned how to write Markdown. Yeah. So yeah. It's coming soon. And the next one is about create a new note from the selection. So you can create a new note from the editor directory, like so. So when you debug, so when it's useful is when you are debugging, and you find another bug, another issue, and you have to write down, and you find that it's a big issue, so you have to create another note because it's gonna be longer. So this feature helps you make another note from the selection like this. So you can select text and right click and new note from selection, and enter the note title like new bug and press enter. So then you can so now you have a new note, and also you have a backlink from the original note here. You can have an original note here, so you can quickly go back to the new bug like this, which is useful to create a new note from the for the another bug while debugging the bug, existing bug. And so here's how to do that. Which is useful. Okay. The next one is about Wiki-style link creation. So you can create a new note right from the editing node by writing empty placeholder links like so. So this is a plain Markdown link which has a title but without a URI. So let's create a new link. Link with an empty URI, like so. And it looks like a normal link, but without a URI. But you can click this link, then Inkdrop creates a new node, and you can write a node. And then let's go back, and this is the source node. And it has, where is it? Yeah, here. So now you got a URI to the new node, so you can open it, and you have a backlink, which is cool. Yeah. So then let's talk about the next one. This would be a long-awaited feature. This is a feature for remembering the scroll positions, which means you can open multiple nodes, but it remembers the last scroll position. So as you can see, it has automatically scroll down to the last edited position. Last edited position, so you don't have to scroll down again to resume editing, which is nice, right? Yeah. And the next one is about editor improvements. No. Let me talk about. Yeah. The next improvement is on navigation. So I wanted to the recent version has got support. The last version got a new feature that allows you to click tags on the node list. So if I click the version 5.8 tag, you can filter the current node list with the clicked tag. So you can easily narrow down node list by the tag. But the version 5.7 displays nodes in the best match order, which was annoying for me. I wanted to make it preserve the node list order when clicking a tag on the node list item. Like this. So this node displays nodes in the date updated order in descending order. So I was viewing the nodes with nodes that are sorted by date updated, and after clicking the tag, it preserves the node list order, which is great. So you can quickly narrow down the node list by tags. So I like it. Of course, you can change the node list order by clicking. So yeah, that's it. That's the new feature. Okay. And the next one is also one of the features I like. This is a go to workspace context menu, which is here. So you can click the notebook name, you can click the notebook drop down list. You can click the note list drop down. And this one has been supported in the older version, but this go to workspace menu is a new one. So you can click this, and the note list and the sidebar has changed to the workspace which you clicked. So this is an app notebook, and the focus moves to the sidebar, so you can use the arrow key. Then if this is a sub notebook or a grandchild notebook, you can press back to go up. So you can quickly go around the notebook in the workspace view. I like it. Okay. Now, and next one is the editor improvement. This one is huge. So the GitHub recently officially supported alerts syntax, which allows you to write something called alerts or admonition, which looks like so. And so you can write similar to quote, block quote. So let's create a new one, like insert a block quote and square bracket, exclamation, and note. Then it turns into alert and something important, like so, which is great. And you can also insert alerts from the toolbar here. So you can click this and you can choose one of the alert types and insert alerts, like so. There's one message. Yep, which is cool. This is available from the version 5.8. The next one is also crucial. This has been supported on the mobile version, and it's also available now on the desktop version. So you can what the hell? Yeah. So when you're browsing a web page and you wanted to insert a link to it, you can simply copy the URL and paste here, and then a dialog shows up, and you can select the format to insert. And this one has a web page title and the URL automatically fetched from the website, so you don't have to copy and paste the page title manually, and so you can insert it. Yeah, I like it. Also, and it's a small improvement, but it's helpful, which is the toolbar button, which allows you to create a link, and it now has a dialogue. To insert a link, so link title, something like that. So you don't have to remember the format. Yep. And next one is a UI improvement. So as you can see, it got the focus outline, right? So it's a better for the accessibility, I think. So you can, basically every component has a focus outline. So it helps you to, control the app through the keyboard. Yeah. So I think it's important for many people. Okay. And also, it got better appearances for the dark UI theme. So it has been It has been not so beautiful before. So this is a new UI, and this is old look. So as you can see, it's kind of strange to have a solid tag appearances on the dark UI, but it now has a more cohesive or match it. They match the UI theme. So I hope you like it. Also, there are so many bug fixes and improvements. One of this one is to drop jQuery finally. So I successfully dropped the jQuery by replacing the drop down menu and other components which depend on the jQuery. Because the components are built with a semantic UI, and I had to use jQuery because the semantic UI depended on jQuery. But I decided to replace them with a React component, simple React implementations. Yep. So it improves the launch speed a bit, slightly. Yeah, but simpler implementation. I love it. Yeah, and other improvement. So let's see. Yeah, and I'd like to say thank you to the community. So thank you for the feedback during the beta testing. So thank you, Piculesilo, for the feedback, and also help me improve the UI by giving me a feedback. Lucas, thank you. Also thank you to Tarsin for the for the bug reports. Also, Shimizu-san, thank you so much. So that's the version 5.8. So I hope you like it. So I have to mention that for the UI theme developers, it got a bunch of improvements in the theming. So if you are a UI theme developer, please check out the change log of the default dark UI theme to support the latest version appearances, which are basically simple. It got a CSS variable based implementation, so other themes can easily customize the colors. So this one is a focused outline offset and focused outline color. So you can change this focus outline color and offset and width easily. Yeah, so please check it out. Yeah, that's it. So thank you again. Yes, so thanks again. Hope you like it.